Very sad story. A woman shot by a racist driver. Okay? Driver not arrested because the driver claimed self-defense. Let's put up the picture of the young lady who's the victim here, all right? Her name is Aaliyah Ivory. She's 24 years of age. She's a mother from Chicago. On Saturday, a black woman was shot 6 times by a racist driver who has not been charged because that driver is claiming self-defense. So let me give you some background as to how this happened. According to reports, that young lady, Aaliyah Ivory, says she was driving to Merge on the Interstate 57 northbound from Lincoln Highway on July 16th. But another driver blocked her and tried to run her off the road. Miss Ivory tried to cut him back off, and the driver caught up with Ivory and called her a racial slur. That's according to her. Ivory clapped back. The next thing you know, bullets started to shoot. Ivory's sister, Ashlee Johnson, told WGN News. Let me show you the car. Let me show you how the car looks. You see, those are bullet holes in the back of the window. Okay? The gunman shot through the back of the car window 5 times and the side window once. All 6 bullets hit the young Aaliyah Ivory. All of the bullets hit her. Here's what she looks like now. Okay? She's been shot 6 times. Doctors are unsure if she will ever be able to walk again. Her injuries, her damage is significant. Miss Ivory has a bullet lodged in her spine and has major damage to other parts of her body. One surgery she has to have is in her hand because she threw her hand up to block the bullets, her sister said. It shattered like 30 bones in her hand, according to the sister. Let me show you a picture of the guy they handcuffed. We're going to get to the bottom of this as much as we can. This is a photo of the alleged shooter, handcuffed. He was put in the back of a police vehicle. The gunman tried to claim self-defense. Although Aaliyah's gun was concealed and it was in its gun holster, Aaliyah explains that she never reached for the gun during the incident. Never. The shooter told someone, "I drew my gun at him. We are both concealed carry, so I was so scared I couldn't even get to my gun fast enough," Ivory said. "My gun has safety on it. They can do any type of test to see. I never discharged my firearm or anything." Put the picture back up of the young lady. She's in the hospital now. She has 6 bullets inside of her. Put the picture up of the vehicle. 6 bullets went through the back of that car. Now, under what theory is this self-defense being applied here? Does this add up to you? There's more. Charges have not been brought against this particular gunman. Ivory's family say they have not been able to see any police report on this incident and that the shooter has not been charged. Aaliyah is thankful her child was not in the car. Okay? Ivory's 2-year-old daughter normally does ride on the side where the shots were fired. And the mother says this incident could have ended differently. Once again, society showing you that they do not stand up for black women as they should. This woman was shot 6 times. They know exactly who did it. She has a version of the event that is corroborated. The shooter has a version non-corroborated. The shooter is the one that has all the reason in the world to lie, so that he's not arrested for attempted murder. They believe the gunman. They put him in handcuffs, put him in the back of the squad car. They let him go home while the young Miss Ivory has had her life changed forever. The daughter, her family, her parents, friends, everybody will be impacted by this one incident. But the gunman who put 6 bullets in this young African-American woman, but the gunman goes home. Horrendous thoughts here.
Yeah, where's the justice here, you know? And unfortunately, it's not surprising that the gunman was able to go home to his family, that there was no consequence. And it's similar to the cop that we were, the police chief that we were talking about earlier, who admitted on an audio recording that he killed all these people and that he shot somebody else 119 times, and he's fine, you know? He's not in jail anywhere. He doesn't have a job, but I'm sure he'll find another one. And this is yet another instance of that. And I live in Texas, and here it is a real fear that someone on the road has a gun in their glove box or in their center console. And road rage is already incredibly dangerous without introducing a lethal weapon into the equation. You know, people are just trying to live their lives, right? We all need to figure out how to do that together. We all share the same resources like our roads and highways, and we have to be able to live with one another in a way that is somewhat amicable. And guns, they don't do that. They don't help that situation. Guns encourage fear over cooperation. They provide a quick resolution to any problem, but that quick solution means escalating the situation to the most extreme possibility before anyone even tries to find an alternate solution or before anyone even has a chance to do so. It's not a sustainable way to live, and we cannot keep escalating situations and all of society really in such a way where gun violence keeps rising and the people who are perpetuating that gun violence, nothing is happening to them. It's not sustainable.
Yeah, very well said.